Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel. This is Madhuri Taneja and in today's lecture, we are going to study about chapter number 5 of geography, that is water. This is the lecture number 2 from the same chapter and in the previous lecture, we studied about the scarcity of the water, the distribution of the water and we even studied about the water cycle or you can say the hydrological cycle. In today's lecture, we are going to study about the circulation of ocean water, that is the movement of the ocean water. And basically in this major topic, we will be studying in detail about the waves. But before that, the very first question is, what are oceans? Because we are going to study about the ocean circulation or you can say the circulation of ocean water. So we should know what are oceans. The large water bodies are known as oceans. Basically, we have four major oceans in the earth, namely the Pacific Ocean, this is the largest one, the Atlantic Ocean, the Indian Ocean, and the Arctic Ocean. Now, you all know that the movement of the water takes place on the surface of the earth and in the atmosphere in the continuous manner. Continuously जो water है वो move करता रहता है. This we have studied in water cycle also. Similarly, there is a constant movement of water in the seas and oceans. Means जैसे water cycle में continuously move करता है, in the same way water oceans में भी move करता है. That movement is also constant movement. So in this topic, we are going to study about the types of that movement. Basically, in the oceans or in the seas, the water moves, or you can say the movement of the water takes place in three different ways. The three different ways are, first of all, waves, second tides, and the third one is current. So we have three different ways, that is waves, tides, and current. And in today's topic, we will study in detail about the waves. But before that, a blue box is given over here. Here it is written that March 22 is celebrated as World Water Day, which you have to remember that World Water Day is celebrated every year on March 22. Now, why this day is celebrated? This day is celebrated to make the people aware or to create awareness about the need to conserve the water. Basically, the people are taught that they need to conserve the water in every possible way so that they can preserve the water for their future generations or so that the future generation do not face the scarcity of the water. So you have to remember this, that the World Water Day is celebrated each year on March 22. Now we have waves. What are waves? First of all, waves are horizontal motion of the water. That is, in the waves, the movement is taking place in the horizontal direction. That is this direction. Right? This is horizontal and this one is vertical. In the waves, we have the horizontal direction. They are the most common form of ocean movement. Now, what is a wave? A wave is the up and down movement of oceanic water in which alternate rise and fall in the sea surface is noticed. What it means? First of all, it is the rhythmic up and down movement on the surface of the water. Rhythmic up and down means water will move up, it will come down, again up, again down. So the rhythmic alternate up and down is there on the surface of the water, on the surface of the oceans, which is known as waves. And these are due to the blowing of wind. When the wind blows across the surface of the water, it creates waves in the seas and oceans. Now we will be understanding the whole topic of the waves with the help of diagram first. So this is the diagram of a wave and you can see here, this is in horizontal direction. As we have already discussed that the waves are horizontal motion of the water. After that we have some terms. First one is crest, second trough, third amplitude, wavelength. So crest, trough, amplitude, wavelength. Now what are these? First of all, what is crest? The rise in the water is known as crest and the fall in water is known as trough. When the water is rising, that is crest. If the water is falling, then it will be trough. So the top point till where the water will rise is crest and the lowermost point is trough. So this is crest and this is trough. Now we have amplitude. Amplitude is the height. The height which the water will attain during the wave. Like you can see here, the normal level is this. This is the sea level. And the water is rising till this height. Then this will be, from here till here, this will be the amplitude. After that we have wavelength. What is wavelength? The distance between two consecutive crest or distance between two consecutive trough is known as wavelength. What it means? Consecutive means साथ साथ वाली, neighbors. आप ऐसा नहीं करोगे कि आपने एक crest ये ली और एक crest आप ये ले लो. You will not do this. You will take two consecutive crest. दो साथ साथ वाली crest लोगे. For example, one this one and second this one. Now, जो इन दोनों के बीच का distance है, the distance between these two is known as the wavelength. So, what is wavelength? The distance between the two consecutive crest or the distance between the two consecutive trough. दो lower point, दो neighbor lower points का अगर आप distance लोगे, that will be wavelength. You can find the wavelength from any of the two consecutive crest or any of the two consecutive trough. So, what is crest? The rise in the water. What is trough? The fall in the water. What is wavelength? Distance between two consecutive crest and trough. And what is amplitude? Amplitude is the height, as you can see in the diagram, which the water attains during a wave. Now the very important thing, it's not the case in case of a wave that water will start from this point and it will move from here to here. No, this will not be the case. Water does not change the place. When the waves cover a long distance from here till here, what happens is the water particles remain at the same place. जो वाटर के पार्टिकल्स होते हैं वो अपने ही प्लेस पर रहते हैं, बस वो ऊपर जाते हैं नीचे जाते हैं. बेसिकली दिस हैपन्स, इट्स नॉट द केस कि वाटर पार्टिकल्स एक प्लेस से दूसरी प्लेस पर जाएंगे. ऑल्टरनेट और रिदमिक अप एंड डाउन इज देयर. इट विल राइज देन फॉल, राइज फॉल, राइज एंड फॉल. हमें अपीयर ऐसा होता है कि वाटर मूव कर रहा है, बट इन एक्चुअल सेंस द वाटर डज नॉट मूव. अगर अभी ये वाला ऊपर है, ये वाला नीचे है, आफ्टर सम टाइम ये नीचे आ जाएगा और जो ये वाले वाटर पार्टिकल्स हैं ये ऊपर चले जाएंगे. सो रिदमिक एंड ऑल्टरनेट अप एंड डाउन इज देयर, बट द वाटर पार्टिकल्स डज नॉट चेंज देयर प्लेस. द रिमेन एट वन प्लेस. राइट, आई होप द मीनिंग ऑफ द वेव्स एंड द टर्म्स आर क्लियर. नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट ऑल्सो. सो हेयर वी हैव वेव्स आर द हॉरिजॉन्टल मोशन ऑफ द वाटर एंड waves are manifested by the formation of crest and trough. First of all, it means ki jo waves hai usme crest aur trough ki formation hoti hai. But before that, correct the spelling of this crest. This is not crust, it is crest. That is crest. Just do the correction. The spelling is wrong over here. It is crest, crest and trough. What is crest now? It refers to the upper part and the trough is the lower part. The distance between the two consecutive crest or trough is known as the wavelength. This we have discussed. After this, in waves, water does not move from its place. Water kabhi bhi apni place change nahi karta. It moves up and down. For example, agar aapne ek pond mein ek stone feka, stone fekne ki wajah se pani chalega nahi, बट पानी में मूवमेंट होगी, वो ऊपर नीचे होगा. यू कैन डू दिस एक्टिविटी सिटिंग एट योर होम ऑल्सो. जस्ट टेक अ स्मॉल स्टोन एंड थ्रो इट इन द बकेट फुल ऑफ वाटर. यू विल सी द रिपल्स ऑफ द वाटर. दे विल स्टार्ट ट्रेवलिंग फ्रॉम देयर प्लेस ऑफ ऑरिजिन टूवर्ड्स द पेरिफेरी. नाउ वेव्स आर मेनली कॉज्ड बाय द विंड्स. दिस ऑल्सो आई हैव टोल्ड यू. नाउ वेव्स आर ऑफ मेनी टाइप्स लाइक सी स्वेल, सर्फ वेव्स, कैटास्ट्रॉफिक वेव्स. इट डिपेंड्स कि जो वेव्स हैं वो कितनी सडन है, क्या उनका रीज़न है, किस वजह से वेव्स हो रही हैं. अगर एक नॉर्मल विंड की ब्लो होने की वजह से वेव्स होती हैं तो वो डिवास्टेटिंग नहीं होती हैं, उनमें डिस्ट्रक्शन बहुत ज़्यादा नहीं होती. बट सपोज द वेव्स आर ड्यू टू द अंडर वाटर अर्थक्वेक्स, ड्यू टू वोल्केनिक इरप्शन और ड्यू टू एनी सडन फोर्स. अब ये बिल्कुल सडनली होगा तो दे कैन बी वेरी डिजास्ट्रस, दे कैन बी वेरी हाई ऑल्सो. इट डिपेंड्स कि उसका एम्पलीट्यूड कितना है. जितना ज़्यादा एम्पलीट्यूड होगा उतनी ही वेव डिवास्टेटिंग होगी. सो द वेव्स कैन कोज हेवी लॉस ऑफ लाइफ एंड प्रॉपर्टी एट द कोस्टल एरियाज. and these type of waves are known as tsunamis. One such example you all know, once a wave that is a tsunami struck the Indian Ocean on December 26, 2004. This tsunami of 2004 is very, very devastating. It created havoc and heavy loss of life and property in the coastal areas. And the countries which suffered were India, Myanmar, Sri Lanka and Thailand. So basically the waves, they can be as small as the ripples of water and they can be as big as tsunamis and they can be very devastating also. So the waves, they can cause destruction of life and property in the coastal areas.